Sum gives wrong total if false. Here is a tiny Excel trick that fixes it instantly. Double dash. Let's unlock this underrated secret operator. Here is our dataset. KR8 passed off February sales. The goal is simple. Find total units sold across all products. Let's focus on the quantity column. If we just do a normal sum, Excel says 23. But just eyeballing the big orders, 15 plus 13, we already got 28. So something is off. See those little green triangles in the corner? Hover over one. Number is stored as text. It could be a leading space, a leading apostrophe, or something else. Here is a quick, easy fix. Tap double dash before the range. Voila! Excel converts text numbers into real numbers inside the formula. And now, the total is correct. Also, the sample Excel file is linked down below so you can follow along and try it yourself. Next up, let's investigate those unusually large orders. Normally, sales are under 10 units, but some orders spike higher. Let's find out why. We will use the note column with if formula here. If quantity is greater than 10, return the note. Otherwise, return nothing. Good, drag it down the list. The formula triggers on a quantity of 4. The reason? Tax numbers again. Let's fix it with double dash. Now it works. Only the two large orders appear. On sale and bulk purchase for event. We now understand why these outliers happened. Stick around, our last example is a real business scenario, and it will show a clever way to handle multi-criteria in one formula. Now, double dash is great inside formulas, but sometimes we need to clean an entire column to prevent mistakes. In a separate column, we can simply tap equals, double dash, then the cell, and drag it down. Notice a single dash would apply the same logic, but it flips the sign. Double dash cancels it, leaving only the conversion. So that's our pick. Other simple fix, like multiplying 1 or adding 0, could also work. But they all need a helper column. What if we want to clean the original quantity column? You may think, just change the cell format to number from the home tab. Turns out, it doesn't work. Sum still fails. How about text to columns from the data tab? It converts all except for this cell. In the formula bar, we can see somehow the export disguises a formula as text number, and text to columns won't convert. So the fastest trick will then be, tap 1 in any cell, copy it, select the quantity column, right click, paste special and choose multiply. Now everything is a real number. Sum works with or without the double dash. Now the column is clean. Does that mean double dash can only go this far? It's actually still powerful for logical counting. Let's count unusually large numbers from example 2. First, check the condition. Excel returns true if quantity is over 10, and false if not. But we need numerical values. Enter double dash in the front, like this. True becomes 1, false becomes 0. Now we can wrap it in sum to count them. And there we go! Two orders over 10 units. Correct! At this point, you might wonder, why not just use the common solution, COUNTIF? And yes, it works here. But double dash is more versatile, especially when COUNTIF or SUMIF fail. Hold that thought for example 5. Time for a real business question. The regional manager wants to increase cat toy budget in East region, and we need total revenue to justify it. We will use the raw export columns, revenue, region, and product. First criteria, select region, check for East. It gives true or false. Add double dash, wrap in the bracket, converts to ones and zeros. Then do the same for the second criteria. Select product, check for cat toy. Apply double dash in front. We will use the sum product function here. So at the end, select revenue range D4 to D15, hit enter, The result is 15.98. Let's do a quick check. Simply add the two matching cells. Should give 47.94. The issue here is again, revenue columns had some tax numbers. So add a final double dash to the revenue range. Total is correct now. The manager can compare historical revenue and make a data-backed budget decision visit. Now let's test a few alternatives. SUMIFS seems ideal. Let's try it. SUM range, revenue from D4 to D15. Criteria 1 range, region from E4 to E15. First criteria, East. Criteria 2 range, product from S4 to S15. Criteria 2, cat toy. The result is incorrect. What if we add double dash in front of the sum range, like we did with sum product? That actually breaks the formula. Some ifs must work with pure numerical ranges. No wrapping allowed. How about sum formula? Equals sum, first criteria, second criteria, and revenue range. The asterisk symbol here represents the AND logic. And the formula works. But on older version of Excel, it would fail unless you press Ctrl plus Shift plus Enter to handle multiple cells at once. Just pressing Enter won't work. Another common solution we use at work is to have AND formula filter for criteria. First, check the region criteria for each row. Then the product criteria. Multiply both by the revenue value and sum separately at the bottom. The total is correct. But can we combine all that into one formula? It doesn't work. AND formula evaluates row by row, cannot multiply across a whole column. Also, notice double dash is not needed for the sum function or the AND function. Multiplying by revenue converts true or false into 1 or 0 automatically. And lastly, we could convert the revenue column using the paste special method in example 3. Some ifs function now works, but requires actual steps. So if your data is clean, some ifs is perfect. If you want to leave a clear trace of thought process, AND formula is a good choice. If you have modern Excel, some works. If you would like to clean the entire dataset before any calculation, paste special is a solid pick. However, if your data is mixed or you need logical math, sum product plus double dash is the safest. One formula works everywhere, handles multi-criteria mess, and no helper column needed. You may think now, okay great, double dash works good for calculations. But a more common question involves finding records that meet some criteria. Then filter function is better at that. Here comes the bonus example. Using the same criteria from example 5 and the entire KR8 PyStore dataset. We now want to extract all East region cat toy orders. Equals filter, select the whole range B4 to K15. Then first criteria, East region. Second criteria, cat toy product. Or simply apply a filter. Select East from region column, then cat toy from product column. Both give the same result, all matching rows. So filter extracts record. Double dash helps calculate. Different tools for different problems. Double dash prevents hidden errors from sneaking into your reports. It's a simple trick that saves hours of headache. If this saved you from a wrong Excel calculation, like, subscribe, and hit the bell. We'll share more small tricks that prevent big mistakes in Excel